started out with this film, I just thought to make it a more fun experience, to put us in a certain emotional state, and to give it the energy that I wanted the film to have, I really wanted to have a lot of music in it. There was this knee-jerk reaction when we would go out to labels to be like, you know, the Tonya Harding story, and they hadn't seen the film, and they would just say no.
They didn't want their music used in a Tonya Harding film.
In one example, like Dire Straits, whoever, their management, whoever, had said no.
Mark Knopfler was the one that I probably spent the most time crafting the perfect letter, asking him to reconsider, sending him footage, going, just, I beg you to look.
And then he watched the film and said, all right, you can use my song.
That was a breakthrough for us in terms of being able to go, yes, if I can get the artist to turn, watch the film, we can get a lot of denials turned around. Peter Nashel is a composer I hadn't worked with in a long time. And when I saw the scope of what we needed and needed fast, he was just the only person I introduced Craig to.
When I saw it, I mean, I had an immediately positive reaction. The way it played down, the performances were incredible. The writing was incredible. I thought Craig did a fantastic job of just kind of capturing that universe and capturing that world.
I don't like score to highlight the comedy. It's always for mood or emotion or tension. I always like to have this duality where it's sort of dramatic and funny at the same time. It's such a tricky thing to do musically, and so I think it's such a small range of composers that can do that.
My role was really trying to underline what's happening with Tonya and Jeff as they kind of move through this insane journey that they went on.
Mark Batson is an amazing record producer I brought in. He ended up writing our title logo song that we reprised in the movie.
There was a scene in the movie, action sequence, where a kind of cool car, you know, flips around. You know, they needed to get that slick sound, that hardcore 70s attitude. The first idea just clicked with the director. You know, Craig just thought it was great instantly. And then he loved it so much, he put the music at the beginning of the film as well.
At the end, it's actually leaving you with something more than just a brief entertainment. It really calls into question a lot of things that are happening today.
I highly recommend anybody to go see this movie. I don't think I want to tell you where.